I have seen two total eclipses, like four annular eclipses, and I don't know how many lunar eclipses, but a lot, yeah. So seeing another eclipse, I think it's one of the greatest things in your life. If you have not seen one, you should try it, because they are, it's awesome. My first eclipse was in the countryside in Colombia. It was in a farm. We went with my colleagues and students, and you could see how the chickens and the rooster, everybody's going home, sleep. And then after about 2 minutes, they're just getting out, and you can understand that the animals are not understanding what is happening. For the Megamovie, well, that's an, in the words of other people, it's an epic endeavor. It's trying to make from an astronomical event that is just a few minutes, something that is 1 hour, an observation of 1 hour. So that's exciting. The basic idea of the Megamovie is that everybody in this country should be taking photos of the eclipse. So you can imagine people from along that path taking images all the time, so we can create an image, a movie of all, with all those pictures. So in reality, it's not us taking the images as scientists, it's normal people taking pictures as scientists will do. So in that sense, this is a very important project. I can imagine a lot of kids taking photos of the eclipse, and those are the kids that eventually are going to be the scientists in 20 years, just because they were involved in something that is bigger than just 2 minutes of darkness. When you have an eclipse, what you are seeing is the solar corona, the outer solar corona. So what we want to observe is coronal rain. If we are lucky, we want to see coronal mass ejections and flows. We want to see how the structure of the corona does change in those 1 hour. How it is changing in 1 hour, nobody knows. So this is unique. It's a unique opportunity. We want to understand how waves propagate in the solar corona. And more importantly, how those waves are related to the solar wind.